Hey, and welcome to the show. I'm the Crypto Kid, and in these videos, we take a look at Bitcoin and everything that's going on in the world of cryptocurrency. So if you're new to the show, welcome. We make daily videos and keep it relevant to what's going on in the news. And if you're joining us again, welcome back. Let's jump right in because it has been a pretty wild day again for Bitcoin BCH. Now let's jump right over, take a look to see the price. And as you can see, I want to see we're sitting at 2,400, but it's more like we are on a steady climb, and we have been over the past 4 to 6 hours, to say the least. Now, we were sitting on the 16th of December at around $1,700. That's only 3 days ago. Now, we are currently at around 2,400, and it seems as though there's no sign of slowing down. Pretty incredible gains here. And why wouldn't there be? Because there is so much in the news for Bitcoin Cash. But we can't just stop there, because across the board, we are seeing some pretty incredible gains. Now, Bitcoin Cash is up in the top gainers, to say the least. But not just that, there's also Ethereum. And if we look at the spread here across the last 7 days, give it a sec to load here, you can see that there is considerable gain across the week here, as we've gotten closer and closer to some all-time highs for many of these cryptocurrencies. Now, more notably, we've got Ripple here, which is showing some pretty serious gains. I don't follow Ripple myself, but I do see that there is some good signs all over, especially with Ethereum. And I will show a video here that I was watching the other day with the creator Vitalik Buterin. Now, what he was doing is he was talking about specifically decentralization. Now, this video is courtesy of an event. I believe it was Event Horizon back in October of this year. And he spoke about Ethereum, not only about his ongoing efforts with his project Ethereum, but he's talking about decentralization, obviously with different monopolies that are involved in the industry here. But he's talking about his perception and his definition of what decentralization is, and not only that, how he broke it down into three areas: architecture, logistics, and who is involved with that. But I'll leave a link in the description box. I would invite you to check it out. It's a really cool perspective on the importance of decentralization, but not only that, but how it's not the sole purpose of Bitcoin. It's a means of an end, and there is also different utilities that you can use with Ethereum. But again, I'll leave the description box because it's definitely worth checking out. Also, I wanted to mention out that keep in mind when we talk about Bitcoin on this site, I am referring to Bitcoin Cash. Why? Because Bitcoin was created to be a peer-to-peer electronic cash system. And clearly, when you compare Core to that theory, it just doesn't hold water. Not only that, the fees are insane, and I can't even use it to purchase things in my daily life without getting hit with those heavy fees. So Bitcoin Cash, in my opinion, is Bitcoin based on the white paper that was created as the plan for Bitcoin. Now, in my opinion, this will only continue as Bitcoin Cash is a friend to commerce. It's accepted by small businesses, and you can use it in your day-to-day life. So again, I'm just going to leave that with you. But keep in mind, I'm not claiming that it is going to be the best alternative in the long run, but right now it works. There's no reason to use anything else, in my opinion, as a payment system. But keep in mind, there are over 20 different coins claiming to be Bitcoin associated. Bitcoin Gold, more recently, you might have heard of, maybe even Bitcoin Diamond, but there is a lot of names. Some of these have nothing to do with Bitcoin. They're just putting the name in front of them and hoping that they'll take off. But keep in mind, and I'll leave it at this, but Bitcoin Cash is what is described in the Satoshi Nakamoto white paper. It is the reason that I got on board with Bitcoin in the first place, because it does act as a digital currency, allowing for low fees, fast transactions. But not only that, there is future there for everybody, you know, to create economic freedom, or even just to buy a loaf of bread at the convenience store without having to ask permission. So again, I'll leave you with that, but that is my opinion. Now, some news over on Bitcoin.com is over in India. And yes, that's right, India is talking crypto, but they are looking to figure out what people are doing. And, you know, keep in mind that Bitcoin is not regulated in India yet. They are just sticking their fingers into the money pit. You know, the government wants to be involved with you and your money. They want a piece of the pie, in my opinion. Here's why. They're using the Income Tax Act. They're using tax evasion laws. They're using these laws that have been put in place by the government to find out more about you, what you're spending your money on, who you're spending it with. Here's a quote here. The Income Tax Act, which is been used to gather evidence for establishing the identity of investors and traders, the transaction undertaken by them, identities of their counterparties, and related bank accounts used, among others. Well, I'll tell you what, if I was living in India, I would want to know exactly what these others are, because if they're already looking to see where I'm sending money, how much, what other bank accounts I have, that's a lot of information they're pulling. So in my opinion, they're trying to regulate, but they're also trying to get a piece of the pie, because look, if they're regulating ICOs or if they're looking to ban them or whatever they might end up doing, they are putting out warnings for anti-money laundering issues, and they are looking at ways to warn the public. But I mean, in my opinion, this really just does cripple and put hurdles in front of these innovators that are trying to get out there and make the world a better place. Because, you know, there's a lot of things on this earth that can harm you, you know, whether it's alcohol, violence, you know, cigarettes is one example. If you want to smoke, that's up to you. I would never stop you from doing it, but you have to know the risks that are involved in that. And just like anything, you know, it should be up to you if you want to go out and get a cigarette and smoke it. I don't smoke, but, you know, if that's what you want to do, go for it. And same with the ICOs. I mean, you don't have to invest in them. And there's a lot other things on this earth that are a lot more dangerous and more detrimental to your health. So in my opinion, this just hampers and hinders the ongoing efforts for small businesses and entrepreneurs to really gather money. And with that said, I mean, 90% of these ICOs and coins that we look at are pure junk. Let's face it. There's no real value here. But with that said, I can guarantee you that a lot of these companies and these blockchains and these cryptocurrencies will become the future. It's just inescapable. So again, you know, when we talk about places like India that are really trying to clamp down, it's not going to stop Bitcoin. It's not going to hinder the progress. It will just slow it down, if anything. So keep that in mind, especially if you live out in India, that they will be looking at you if you've got a lot of money in Bitcoin, or if you have over the past years. But yeah, do your due diligence, you know, check out the taxes if you want, because, you know, if you live in the States or myself in Canada, they'll come after you. So I just do everything I can to prevent that from happening. But I will advise that you do your research before investing in anything. So again, I'll leave a link to this in the description box below, because it is pretty interesting to see Vitalik's true definition of what he believes decentralization, as well as the importance of some areas becoming centralized, some areas becoming less decentralized. So it's a really interesting talk. I'll invite you to check it out. Otherwise, if you're looking for an exchange, Quadriga CX is a Canadian exchange here. It allows you to trade Bitcoin Core, Ethereum, as well as doing trades directly between Canadian funds and Ethereum. So that's pretty cool, as well as trading Bitcoin Cash with Canadian funds. Pretty exciting stuff, but it also allows you to fund in USD and other cryptocurrencies. Check it out. I'll leave a link as usual. And hopefully today's video was enjoyed. And I will continue to monitor this incredible ongoing price with Bitcoin Cash, especially if you're looking to invest now. Keep an eye on it, because, you know, it could continue to go up, but you might see some retracement too. So just be cautious. And again, follow us on Twitter if you want to tap into that live news, because today anything can happen. So thanks for watching. It's been a pleasure, and we will see you in the next one.